Hello everyone, welcome to the Smarty Techie. Today we are learning about the indexes in MongoDB. So in this session we will be checking that how we can create the indexes, how we can get the indexes, and what are the different uses of the indexes. So actually the indexes are something when we have a query, so that any find query you are using, it may take several time to execute and give you a certain output. So sometimes it may get executed very easily if you have very less number of records, but sometimes it will get to know that it is taking too much time, that if you are having a number of records that is around GBs and something else, so it may slow your application. So what are the things which we need to do? That is the first thing. Please create your indexes. Actually the indexes helps to if you're not having any indexes on your application, actually what the MongoDB does for your find queries, it performs the collection scan. What does the collection scan means? Collection scan means it will scan all the documents present in the in your collection and give you and then get the particular items that you are that you want to get in your output, then it give you the result. Okay, so scanning every collection, obviously in the number of in thousand or hundreds of records it will be easy, but in records like 1000 or 2000 or in lakhs, it will become very difficult for us to wait for a few seconds, and then it can slow your system. So when we can use indexes, firstly when we are having a number of records, then you can use indexes. When you have your application need to query a find only, most of the time it will be the find, then you can use indexes. So these are the things which we need to use indexes or not. For example, if your application only dump anything in it, then there is no need of indexes, that is automatically uses the ID indexes. So at that time when you are having update queries or insert queries, update when you have a find and update, then you should have a indexes on your system, because for finding something it will obviously consume your memory. Okay, so when we have a number of when you want to insert something, your application doing the insert operation much more, then please try to avoid create indexes, because indexes do take memory to create, and obviously IOPS will get increased for it. So let's see how we can create an index on our document. So this is a document related to the indexes given in the docs.mongodb.com. You can check, for example you have a DB, you have a collection users, and you want to find you have a find query, that is find a collection where find a document in a collection users where the users have the score less than 30, then we need to sort it according to the score descending order. Minus 1 here means the descending order. So what will it does, if you are not having a indexes, it will check for every collection in your table. But in that case, if you are having a index on the score key, then what will it does, it will check, okay, it have a value of 30, then what it need to be done, it will for the score in index, it actually stores a value of a specific field or a set of fields ordered by the value of the field. The ordering of the index entry supports sufficient quality matches and range. So it will actually make your queries to ordered and to find the result very easy and very easy to traverse. So what will it does, it will only check for the document keys from here to here only. There is no need to check for other documents. Actually it stored in a by using the ordering in the index. So that's why it will help to minimize the context of the documents available, and then we'll only use the keys for the that particular document reside in the between of this to 30. The index actually same as the other DB database indexes, like the indexes in the SQL, MySQL. So it will only, it will same something like that. And actually the indexes in this can be done on the field or any subfield. Any subfield means any nested fields as well. Okay, so let's see how we can use the indexes. For example, let's say I have, this is my Mongo console. I am connected to my localhost Mongo console. There is a DB Smarty Techie. So what I have done, I have just inserted the documents in the products collection. So let's say if it is having any indexes on it or not. So db dot get db dot products dot get indexes. So you can check there. I didn't created any index on it. By default, the MongoDB does that. For the ID underscore ID field, it automatically creates an index. So if you are having a query on the underscore ID field, then there is no need to create an extra index for it. Actually, if you will create an extra index on the underscore ID, it will tell you that it is already exist. So we do not have to create an index on this field. So if we want to query on, let's say I want to query on ID itself, so it will give you the output using the underscore ID field index only. So there is no need to create an index on underscore ID. But in that case, actually I have only having the three documents in it, so it will give you the output very easily. But in case if I having the documents like thousands or 2000 or lack of document, then what will we do? If let's say if I want to query on the item field and there is no index on the item, so it will give you the output in very less seconds. It will give you something, some milliseconds. It may take some milliseconds or minute as well if you have a number of documents in it. So let's say I will also show you that how can I get to know that if it use the index or not. Okay, item, let's see card. So yeah, it is giving us the output very easily, but as it doesn't have, but it doesn't have any indexes on the item field. And you need to, if you want to query on the item field, so firstly we will create index on the item field. So let's say db dot create index db dot products dot create index, and the indexes I need to create is on item. So if you want to create index in the ascending order, ascending here means if, as I said you earlier, that the indexes store the document in the ascending or descending order. If you having a query much more in the descending way, so please create your index in descending. And if you are not supposing that it may be ascending, it may be descending, then you can create the index on the ascending in ascending order. If you will, so right here one, it will be work as the ascending indexes, and if you write here -1, it will take it as a descending order. So we will create here as a 1, as I want to create index in the ascending order only. So you can see that created collection automatically false because our collection is already created. Now, before creating this index, we have only one index, that is only the underscore ID. In number indexes, after now it is 2 because we have created one more index, that is the item. Operation time, then it is all the times including in time including in it. Now let's see if we have the indexes or not. So now we have two indexes, that is underscore ID and the item. There are several notes that you important notes you need to be clear on, that please do not create indexes on your system while having a much load on it. Because for example, when you create an index, it actually blocks all the write operation on your DB. So if you're having a workload, if you're having a user load on your application and it is having a your application is running through it, and suddenly if you created an index on it and then the write operation just stop on it, then it will be going to very difficult for you to handle all the things. Then in that case, please do not create index on the working hours of your application. Try to create index on the non-working hours, like for example at night if it is not having a much load on it. But in that case, still you have to if you're having a workload or if you're having a user's load on the non-working hours or as well, then what you need to do, you may create an index using the background. Background true. What it will does, it will not stop your write operations on your DB, but still I am suggesting that please do not take it on the on your working application on the working hours, because it may take some time and it will consume more RAM to execute your indexes. So sometime it may be your system gets stopped, so please do not try to avoid to use in the daytime when you're having a lot much more load on your application. So you can use the background rule. What will it does, it will not stop your write operation on your DB, but yes, the indexes will create very indexes created will be in a very slow manner. That is, maybe if in two index, if the indexes are will create in the 5 minutes, maybe it will take 10 minutes to create. I'm just giving you the example, it will take more time. So by using the background true option, you can able to create indexes while it will not stop the write operation on your DB. So to verify if it is working on background or not, then you if you will check, okay, it says all indexes already exist. So if you want to check that if the indexes are creating in background or not, in the logs, when you can check the logs of the MongoDB, it will show you the background true option as well. So you can check whether the indexes are created or not. So this is something about the indexes here. I will create the next part too. So we'll let you know that how I can identify that if my query is using the indexes or not, if I need to create indexes or not. So these are something which we need to define like this, and this is something like the explain in the MySQL as well or SQL as well. So we will check this in the next part. So till now, keep learning.